For all my thumbnails that are more than just a simple photo, I use Adobe's Creative Cloud Express. In this video, I want to show you how to create a thumbnail from start to finish in under 10 minutes using Creative Cloud Express. One and a half years ago, I made a tutorial on my channel about Adobe's web-based design tool, Adobe Spark. Now that video popped up in my most watched videos in the last month, which surprised me because it's almost 2 years old and it's a little bit outdated. So I thought I should make a 2022 version. If you found my channel through that video, then give the video a like or drop a thumbs up in the comments below. And if you're new here, my name is Dan. I make videos about being a part-time YouTuber and being an expat living in Australia. Not only has the name changed since I made that video from Adobe Spark to Adobe Creative Cloud Express, Adobe also added a bunch of new features that make the software so much better and a viable alternative to the immensely popular Canva. The reason why I don't use Canva is because it would be another subscription to pay for when there's a similar tool available through my Adobe Creative Cloud subscription that I'm using anyway for software like Premiere Pro or Lightroom or Photoshop. Okay, I'm going to use the web-based tool to show you how to create a thumbnail from start to finish. By showing you my process, I hope that you can get familiar with the software and you get ideas how to use Adobe Creative Cloud for your own thumbnails. I don't like spending hours and hours on my thumbnails, so this should give you a way to create thumbnails in about 10 minutes or less. As an example, I will be using one of my recent thumbnails that uses a few design elements from within Creative Cloud Express and external, so I can show you how to put it all together in the web tool. Shout out to any expat viewers out there. That video was about vlogging tips for expats. I'll link it up here in case you want to check that out. Okay, let's jump into Adobe Creative Cloud Express. So this is the homepage of the web tool. And from here, you can already select some of the templates as a starting point. So for whatever you want to create, if you want to create an Instagram story, an Instagram post, Facebook or flyers or invitations, whatever your heart desires, you can pick here. Scrolling down, you have a few more templates for the different post types that you can choose from, but they also have a huge template library that we are going in now, because down here we don't have anything for YouTube thumbnails. So if you want to see where the YouTube thumbnails are, we click on the little plus icon here and view all. And then on the side here we have YouTube thumbnail templates. So here you have a bunch of different options for YouTube thumbnails that are already here for you to make your own, where you can just change images or change the text, but a lot of different options if you want to start creating based on one of those. But we want to start from scratch, so we are going back to the homepage, back to the plus icon, and we click on custom size graphic. And under popular, you have the YouTube thumbnail template, which is 1280 by 720. And then we go into the project itself. So you can give the project a name. I'm just going to call it thumbnail. And this is basically your workspace. On the left here, you have a toolbar for all the different design elements and assets you can add to your image. So we've got, you can again choose a template here. You can use text, upload a photo, icons, different design assets such as images, textures, lines, different backgrounds. And then you have logos. If you have uploaded your own logos into the tool, then these would be available here. And then your own library. Here on the right side, we've got the tools to customize the design assets that you add to your image, but we'll get to that a little later. Okay, so we want to start with a photo that you can upload here on the left. You can choose photos that Creative Cloud Express suggests here in the sidebar, or you can upload your own photo. You can also connect your Lightroom, Dropbox, or Google Drive or Google Photos to sort of have access to your library, which is great. but I'm gonna upload it from my desktop. So I've got this photo here that I'm gonna upload, and I click on it to add it to the background to make it basically fill out the whole canvas. And then here you have already some tools to customize your image. Now you could add some filters or make adjustments such as increase brightness, contrast, change the saturation or the sharpness. I usually don't do much with this because I already edited the photo in Lightroom before uploading it to Creative Cloud Express. So we'll just leave it as that. Now with this thumbnail, because it's for an expat related video, I wanted a little bit of a travel theme. So I wanted different design elements that relate to travel on the thumbnail. So the first idea that I had was to add a world map behind my body here. Now for that, I just went on Google and I found a world map, a dotted world map with a transparent background, which I can add to this image now. So go back to photos, upload photo, and the world map. Now this is light gray, so you don't even see it here. And because of that, I would now use the adjustments here. And I think by just increasing the contrast, it's already much better. And I actually only want it quite subtle, so I'm happy with that. Maybe I'll just do it a little bit darker. Obviously, this is not behind my body. It's actually all across my face. And to bring this into the background, I now basically need to add another layer of my image. And for that, I did a version. I have a version of this image where my body is cut out and on a transparent background, which I did in Photoshop, which is a very easy thing to do these days in Photoshop. I usually find Photoshop so difficult, but this is actually quite easy, and I do it quite often. And yeah, if you want, I can show you that in a different video, but we're not going to go into that here. So let me upload that cut out image. That's that. All right, then you see here I just need to match the size of the background. Like this. All right. Okay, so now the map is in the background. And something that's great that Adobe added not too long ago to this tool is the layers down here. So you've got the background layer that is static, but then all the elements that you add to your image are here as layers. So you can swap the order, and you can decide at any given time what you want to bring forward to the foreground or put to the background. Very easy, just by dragging and dropping it here between the layers. All right, now I want to add some text here to the right side of the image. And for this, I just go to the toolbar and add a new text. And I'm just gonna say, share your life. And then you can customize your text. You can change the color, change the font. And I'm just gonna use this and change it to maybe white. And then you can also add little text elements such as a shape. Just wanna have a bright orange. And you can also add a shadow or an outline. So these are the different options that you have for the text. And also you can choose different types of shapes. You can even mask the text, which is really cool as well, if you want it to be transparent. Now, sometimes I want to have I want to only highlight certain words with the shape. For that, you can create a secondary style or highlight style, what they call it here. And you can have a different color or a different font for that particular text. So you see the first word changed here. And by clicking the different words of your text, I can either add it to the highlight customization or remove it from it. Maybe I even make the text black. All right. All right, now that I have my text here, I want to add a few more design elements that are related to travel. And for that, I click into the design assets and then I just explore what's available here. So I'm wondering if there is a passport, for example. And I do have two images of passports, so I'll just use that. And that is orange as well, just perfect. Put this down here. I might actually want to match the color of the shape to this. To do that, I just click on the text again, click on the shape, on the color, and then use this little eyedropper to pick the color that I want. So now it matches it better. And then I want to add a globe as well. Let's see what we have for a globe. Okay, a few different options. I think I like this one. I'm saying it as if I've never done this image before, but obviously, you know, I've done it before, so I know exactly what I'm selecting. All right. So now again, I actually want it behind the passport. So for this, I can go back into the layers down here and then just drop it underneath the passport and then rearrange it a little bit. Okay, we're almost done with our image now. I just want to add a few last elements to the left side here. And what I thought about was adding a line and an icon for an airplane and for a location pin, just to represent travel and going from one place to another. So for that, I'm going into the icons panel here, and I start by looking for a location pin. And there are quite a few options here. I just go with this one. You can then again change the color. I think I'm gonna do it in white and put it up here. Now I want a line, but not a solid line. I'm trying to find a dotted line. Okay. I think I'm just gonna go with this one. And this, I might just do an orange again with the same color. Like this. Yeah. And then one last icon, which is the airplane. We'll use that. And I'll change that to white as well. And then I just put it somewhere along the line so that it looks like we're on our way to our new home. All right, and then we are done with the image. I'm happy with the final result and we are ready to export it. So to export the image, you just click on download here on the top right corner, and then you have different options, the PNG, JPEG, and PDF option to download your image. I usually use JPEG and click on start download, and then it lands in my downloads folder. After exporting the final image and before uploading it to YouTube, I usually test my thumbnails and titles on thumbsup.tv. If you're not familiar with that site, it basically shows you how your thumbnail and title shows up on different devices and in different places on YouTube, which is really handy for you to figure out the best title and thumbnail combo for your videos. After testing it, I usually end up going back into Creative Cloud Express to do a few more tweaks until I'm happy with the final result. If you found this tutorial helpful, then give it a thumbs up and tell me in the comments below if you were already familiar with Creative Cloud Express and if you're already using it for your thumbnails. If you enjoyed this video, I think you might like this one up here as well, where I share how I keep track of all my video ideas for my channel using Notion. Thanks so much for watching, and I hope I'll see you in the next one. Take care.